Your Life, an American television tradition. And now, here he is, Mr. This Is Your Life himself, Ralph Edwards.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, welcome to this edition of This Is Your Life. We have a special lady tonight. You know her as your principal. We know her as someone who's lived over 5 decades. That's a long time, kids. Now, let me tell you, that's almost a half century. In fact, it is. So let's introduce her right now. Here's your principal, Mrs. Sitko. Well, let's get on with our show because we have a long life to cover. Our first guest was Mrs. Sitko's first teacher. Let's see if she remembers who he was.
I told you to get your head out of the clouds, but put them into the stars.
No, I can't think who it is.
Haha, Mrs. Sitko, I think you mean the words can't.
Yes, that's what I said. Can't.
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 Well, whatever you say, here he is, Galileo.
Galileo was an Italian physicist, mathematician, astronomer, and philosopher who played a major role in the scientific revolution. He's been called the father of modern astronomy and physics. His achievements included improvements to the telescope, he invented the Galileo thermometer, and made this thingy.
He also discovered the 4 moons of Jupiter and proved that Venus has phases just like the moon. He also confirmed that the Earth rotated around... wait?
Mrs. Sitko, the world doesn't revolve around you. Now let's take a quick look at a clip of you and your first family pet playing together. What a cute little doggy. Well, let's move on. We all know, kids, that as you get older, the mind and the body start to change. They change so the mind doesn't think ahead all the time and begins to take risks, if you will. Let's go to one of Mrs. Sitko's crazy adventures, where she may not have thought things through and decided to take a leap. Yes, yes, perseverance indeed. Some of you might not know why we're celebrating Mrs. Sitko today. Well, kids, it's the fact that Mrs. Sitko is actually turning 50. What is 50? 50 is such a large number that I'm going to need some examples to show you what 50 really means to people. So the best way to do that is to use base 10 blocks. So if I want to make 50, I would use how many groups of 10, kids? That's right, 5. Do you see how tall these are? And you see how many I have to put in this little box? That's because 50 is such a huge number. Let me show you another way to make 50. Let's take those out, and we're actually going to move the 1 blocks in. How many of these do you think I'm going to need? That's right again, 50 of them. So when I drag 50 in, then you'll know exactly how many we need to equal someone's birthday. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Wow, that's a lot. I don't even know if I can fit 50 in here. So you know what, I better do some magic here, and I better clone these up. All right, so we're going to need way more than this. I think my program's breaking down. I don't think I can handle this many. All right, this has been a short lesson on what is 50, and we're just going to have to add a couple more of these because 50 is such a huge number.
Well, now that we know how big a number 50 is, when do you actually turn 50, Mrs. Sitko?
Tomorrow from 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock. Please write it in your agenda.
Well, I'll be sure to mark that down.
Well, Mrs. Sitko, how's it feel to know that you're on your way to that grand old century mark now?
From the office, the buses have already left.
I bet they have. Any final words, Mrs. Sitko?